Hi guys, have you ever heard the rule, never sign unless you read the fine print? Well, that's really interesting because we're doing the sign rule and in the question there is a lot of fine print that we got to check out. And let me just read it to you. The fine print says this. It says, find the angle theta if it is obtuse in fine print. That means that this is the angle we're looking for, theta, right around here. And you might notice that it does look obtuse. Obtuse meaning, as you know, greater than 90 degrees. So that looks kind of big, doesn't it? So that's what we're looking for. So there's a little trick in this and I'm going to walk you through it. And you're going to see exactly what to do when you get a question like this. Now, this is one of those tougher questions. But at the same time, we're going to learn how to do and find angles instead of lengths using the sine rule. So let's get into the details of this. This is the sine rule formula equation, whatever you want to call it. And I'm going to give you a little quick shortcut on how to do this without having to refer to the sine rule all the time. Since we know it's all about cross multiplication, what we're going to do is just go angle and distance, angle and distance, and put distance over the angle. That's all we do in cross multiply. Let's do that now. So let's start off with distance over angle. Let's do that. Distance over sine of the angle, which equals distance over sine of the angle. Okay, there we have the basic equation. Let's do what we normally do with sine rule, and that is to cross multiply. Let's do that. So first of all, we're going to get this corner times that corner. It's equal to that corner times that corner. Okay, what are we after now? We're after the angle theta right over here. So that means we want to isolate and make singular this theta right there. So let me just underline that because this is what we're going for. Right there. So what do? We divide both sides by 100 to get rid of that 100 to leave this by itself. So let's do that. So that's going to give us there we go, sine theta equals 210 times sine 26 all over 100. Let's put that in the calculator. So 210 times sine 26 divided by 100 gives us 0.9206. We are after theta by itself. So let's shift sine now. We shift sine and that'll give us 67 degrees, 0 minutes, 40 seconds. Remember, just before we got that answer, we also press shift DMS or degrees, minutes, seconds, and it'll yield 67 degrees, 0 minutes, 40 seconds. That can be rounded up to 67 degrees, 1 minute, because the 40, that's above 30. Let's do that. Let's write that over here. So the answer we have for theta is 67 degrees, 1 minute, yeah? Okay, that's what we have now, but it's not obtuse. Remember the fine print? Read the fine print in the question. So we want to check this out, 6701, what do we do? How do we make it obtuse? That angle does look obtuse. It does look bigger than 90 degrees. So what we do quite simply is take it away from 180 degrees. That'll make it obtuse. So let's do that. Let's go. Take away the 6701, and that's going to give us a grand total 180 minus 6701 is going to give us the angle. On your calculator, 180 minus 6701, the angle right in here is theta is
30. Take a minute to check out our website at http://www.vividmaths.com. You'll find additional resources, cheat sheets, transcripts, and other maths videos that are not available on YouTube. Lastly, don't forget to subscribe to get access to all the written answers for your maths questions, plus other special offers.